The very first thing that you have to do is you have to treat this forage as if it were a true crop. And talking about it in the southeastern United States, and saying that it's a crop, what producers would equate that to is maybe a row crop producer that's producing corn, or they're producing cotton, or producing peanuts. They see that as a true crop. They attach an importance level to it. That's an intentional attachment of importance. And if you first start out with that forage production and recognizing that it is a true commodity, it is a true crop, then you can start putting all the pieces of the puzzle together, whether that is to have it at the right maturity and recognize, hey, that's the right maturity, but according to the weather situation, we need to get in there and we need to harvest that right now to take advantage of the nutrients that we have placed into that forage. As my husband likes to say, we have enough factors working against us with weather and with everything else that's going on. You have to start out saying you're going to make the absolute best crop possible, and that I am going to treat this as a crop. I'm going to be timely about my decision making. I'm going to do what the guidances say from our experts, you know, the soil testing, the fertilization, the weed control, the insect control. Am I doing according to manufacturer's instructions on the maintenance of my equipment? If I'm not doing that and making intentional decisions, I'm not going to produce the best quality forage I can make. Well, a soil test is important from the standpoint that it is going to be supplying the forage that's growing on it. It's a living organism, the forage is, and it needs feed. And to keep that forage growing, you're going to have the nutrients there for it to grow from. So whether it's something that needs to address particularly the root system, you know, with like a deep soil sample that tells us a little bit about deep pH in the soil, do we need to correct that to keep the plant growing year after year after year if it's a perennial? Is it something that we need to replace because that forage and pulling it off of that land, is that forage mining that nutrient? So having that soil test, the importance of it is to tell us how to replenish the nutrients that living organism in that plant is needing to be able to grow during that growing season. If it's a perennial field and it is dormant at a particular time of the year, then what we're spending the rest of that year doing is looking back over what we did the previous year, what our results were on what we did do that year. Then we start looking forward and thinking about, okay, well, what do we need to do to be better the next year? Is there something that we can be doing during that off season, whether it's through the soil testing, which is something that we're going to be doing anyway, the application of any nutrients that we need to apply to it. For us in particular, it's equipment. That's the one variable that if we're right in the middle of harvesting and storing, if we've got an equipment issue, then that stops the entire process. So equipment maintenance is critical to us. Well, first off, to recognize there's always going to be a challenge. Cost is probably the one that affects producers the most, along with weather situations. In the case of more recent times, we're thinking about the cost of our nutrient application. If we're looking at increases in fertilizer costs, you know, what type of adjustments do we have to make? And yes, we do have to make adjustments because of that. We have to think about what's our priority. And typically your first priority is going to be is with those nutrients, let's assess the pH of the soil, because science is showing us that the pH is going to determine the uptake of the other nutrients that we have, that we've placed in the soil. And so our first priority would be there, and we're going to meet those cost challenges first. It makes the use of the other nutrients, when you do spend that money for them, it makes them more valuable and more efficient utilization by the plant. I'd like to say that we had a recipe to be able to do this a certain way, and we always get that specific outcome with high forage quality. But reality feeds us a whole different situation. And what that means is sometimes where we're shooting for the absolute best quality that we can, but then adjust our puzzle and our components of that puzzle, of which input cost is a major part of it, and understand by adjusting that, we may adjust the entire puzzle, which is the end result being that it is a high quality forage.